You know, the same way you can track your car's speed with miles or kilometers per hour, you can actually track the speed of your internet connection with megabits per hour. Hello again, everyone. I'm Alana, and I'm back again this week bringing you more useful tech tips, sponsored by Digi. So, if you think your internet connection is way too slow and you want a way to test it out, head over to speedtest.net. It's really useful to know your upload and your download speeds to make sure that your internet service is operating the way that it should. Of course, while finding the numerical data of how fast your Wi-Fi is important, it means nothing if you can't understand what in the world those numbers represent. The great thing about speedtest.net is their knowledge base, which you can access under the About section of their webpage. There, you can find a glossary to help with tricky tech jargon, frequently asked questions, and even different guides to help you try different methods that can optimize your internet speeds. But allow me to explain the basics. When you open Speedtest's webpage, all you have to do is press the Go button and let the site work its magic. Don't be alarmed that it knows your service provider. The website does not collect any of your sensitive data when conducting its test. Your download speed shows how quickly you can retrieve data onto your device from the internet. This shows how quickly you can load a website or a web-based app, receive a WhatsApp message from a friend, or save a song onto your phone. Your upload speed shows how quickly you send out data. This one applies when you post a picture on Instagram, comment on something, or send a funny meme to your group chat for the 20th time in 10 minutes. Speedtest also shows you your ping speed. This is the reaction time of your Wi-Fi. If you're familiar with video game lag, that's what ping speed represents. When you execute a command like pressing the A button to make your character jump and it happens immediately on the screen, you have a good, fast ping speed. For ping, the lower the number, the better. So anything under 100 milliseconds is pretty good. Whew. Let's move on to something with less numbers involved. If your home or business has Wi-Fi, but there are certain pesky areas where finding a connection seems to be impossible, have no fear. You should install a Wi-Fi range extender. The coverage you need can be easily accessible with this device. Say your router is upstairs on one side of your house, but your kitchen is way on the opposite end. You're looking for a recipe, only to realize that nothing can load, because your router's coverage doesn't extend far enough. That's where a range extender, also known as repeater, comes in. It captures your existing signal and amplifies it so that you can surf the net anywhere in your home or office. It can even help you get outdoor coverage in your yard. Now, you can stream playlists for your backyard barbecue with no buffering at all. They're not too pricey, installation isn't long, and in some cases, you don't even have to have a new network and password. Thank goodness. Well, those are my tech tips for today, viewers. So I'll be seeing you again next week. Same time, same place, but with all new tech tips. Good night.